Question number 31. What class of fire was a wet chemical fire extinguisher specially designed to fight? The answer is class F fire. So class F fire means the fire involving cooking oils and fats. Usually this type of fire occur in the galley or kitchen of a ship. So for this type of fires, high temperature is involved. So for that, we have to use a special type of extinguisher called a wet chemical fire extinguisher. Question number 32. Who has the authority to pull the fire alarm after discovering a fire on the work site? The answer is anyone who has seen a fire can activate the fire alarm. So the first thing in fighting the fire is find, inform, restrict, and then extinguish. So it is very important that reporting of the fire. So anyone who has seen a fire can activate the fire alarm in order to report the fire is happening in which location, so that the other crew member of the ship can assemble in the muster station and set up strategy how to fight the fire. Question number 33. You should use a dry powder fire extinguisher in order to fight an electrical fire only in the event of dash. The answer is a carbon dioxide fire extinguisher is unavailable. So CO2 extinguisher, that is carbon dioxide extinguisher, is best suited to fight the electrical fire because it will not damage any machinery, as it will not leave any residues. Okay, but at the same time, when CO2 is not available, we cannot use a water type or a foam type extinguisher. So the next option is to use the dry chemical powder DCP extinguishers. So it can extinguish the electrical fire, but the problem is it may damage the machinery because the powder which leaves the residues in the electrical machineries. Okay. Question number 34. A wet chemical fire extinguishers were specifically designed in order to tackle dash. The answer is class F fire. Okay. So the wet chemical fire extinguishers are used to extinguish the fire involving cooking oils and fats. So usually this fire involves a high temperature. Okay. So for that, we cannot use the ordinary foam or any CO2 or DCP extinguishers. So for that, we have to use the wet chemical type fire extinguishers only. 35. Which of the following is true about dry powder fire extinguisher? The answer is you should avoid using them in confined spaces. Here, when you are using the dry powder extinguisher, that is a dry chemical powder, in a confined space, it will lead to a suffocation, breathing difficulty, because the fine powder go into your nose and then reach the lungs. So it lead to a suffocation and breathing problem. And also the powders, fine powder, may enter into your eyes and cause irritation and trouble in seeing the surrounding. So you should not use the dry chemical powder in the confined spaces. Question number 36. Wood, plastic, and paper, or which of the following? The answer is class A material. Of course, the solid flammable materials like wood, plastic, and paper are categorized as the class A fire materials. Question number 37. Wood, plastic, paper and other solid materials are typically the culprits for dash. The answer is class A, fire. So definitely the wood, plastic, paper or the solid flammable materials. So they are categorized under class A fire only. Question number 38. What type of fire extinguisher should you use in order to extinguish a fire caused by solid material such as wood, paper or textile? The answer is water type extinguisher. So the best firefighting medium for the fire involving the solid materials is water. Okay, the water extinguishes the fire by the technique of cooling. It absorbs the heat so that it will not allow the flammable material to reach the flash point. Okay, so the answer is water. Question number 39. After using a carbon dioxide fire extinguisher, the nozzle gets extremely cold. This is a sign that answer is you should not use it. Why? Because when the nozzle becomes extremely cold, if you touch the nozzle, what could happen is you will end up with frost burns, right? So it will damage your hands. So in that case, you should not use the carbon dioxide extinguisher when the nozzle is extremely cold. Question number 40. What type of permit is needed in order to carry out the work that could potentially result in a fire breaking out on the work site? The answer is a hot work permit. So the hot work permit is issued when you are going to do some hot work like welding or gasketing. Okay, so the permit is issued after ensuring that no hazards are existing nearby, that is no flammable substances are existing nearby, right? So in that case, the hot work is done without carrying out the proper safety procedures, it may lead to a fire accidents. Okay, so the correct answer is a hot work permit. Question number 41. In the event of a fire, everyone is responsible for? The answer is pulling the fire alarm if they see a fire. So the first thing in extinguishing a fire is to report the fire. That is to informing the fire is at a particular location to all other crew. So this can be done by raising the fire alarm when you see the fire at first sight. Question number 42. What type of fire extinguishers would you use on a fire that is categorized as a class F fire? The answer is wet chemical fire extinguishers. So class F fire is the fire involving cooking oils and fats, usually happening in the galley. So for that, a special type of extinguishers called wet chemical fire extinguishers are used to extinguish this fire. Question number 43. A squeeze grip type carbon dioxide portable extinguisher has been partially discharged. It should be dash. The answer is labeled empty and recharged as soon as possible. This is because when you leave the carbon dioxide after partially using the extinguisher, the expanded carbon dioxide from liquid to gas state, there will be a drop in temperature. So this low temperature will solidify the liquid carbon dioxide available inside the container. And once it becomes ice, it cannot be discharged out of the nozzle. So it is of no use. So it is always good practice. Once you use the CO2, use it fully. And if it is left partially inside, it should be labeled empty and recharged as soon as possible. Question number 44. After using a CO2 portable extinguisher, it should be dash. The answer is recharged. So there is no use in keeping the partially used CO2 bottle, CO2 portable extinguisher, because if you leave it like that, the leftover CO2 become solidified and become ice, and it is of no use for the further use for extinguishing the fire. So it should be always labeled it is empty and should be recharged as soon as possible. Question number 45. A definite advantage of using water as a fire extinguishing agent is its characteristics of dash. The answer is a rapid expansion as water absorbs heat and changes to steam. So this is the action of water using as a fire extinguisher. So it absorbs the heat from the fire, and once it absorbs heat, it reaches its boiling point and convert to steam. The steam act as a smothering agent and displaces the air around the fire. So thus it's extinguishing the fire, but both the action by cooling as well as by smothering. Question number 46. A spanner is a dash. So here the answer is a special wrench for the coupling in a fire hose line. So here the spanner means it is a curved wrench like spanner used to couple the fire hose line with the hydrant. So the right answer is a special wrench for the coupling in a fire hose line. Question number 47. A CO2 portable extinguisher is annually checked by dash. The correct answer is weighing the extinguisher. Like other extinguishers, we cannot open up the CO2 extinguisher. It is compressed, pressurized CO2 in the liquid form. So the only way to check the extinguisher is to weigh that CO2 extinguisher. If the weight is less, then it is inferred that some of the CO2 has leaked out. If the weight is same as when it was charged, so in that condition we can say the CO2 is in the fully pressurized condition. Question number 48. A foam type portable fire extinguishers would be most useful in combating a fire in dash. The answer is flammable liquids. So for a fire involving the flammable liquids like petrol, diesel, okay, so the best firefighting medium for them is foam type. For it, this is a B class fire. So this foam type extinguisher extinguishes the fire by smothering action. So it will form as a blanket over the surface of the oil or flammable liquids fire, so that cutting out the oxygen to reach the root of the fire. Question number 49. A fire must be ventilated dash. So in order to prevent the gases of combustion from surrounding the firefighters. Question number 50. A fire of escaping liquid flammable gas is best extinguished by dash. The answer is stopping the flow of gas. So the best practice in extinguish the gaseous fire is to close the supply of gas. That is by closing the wall from where the gas is leaking. That is the only way we can extinguish the fire. So the answer is stopping the flow of gas. Question number 51. A fire in the galley always poses the additional threat of dash. Answer is a grease fire in the ventilation system. So along with the fire happening in the galley due to the cooking oils or fats, and the fire reaches the ventilation ducts, so there you will find the some oily grease. Okay, so whatever the vapors of cooking oil will get deposited on the filters of the ventilation system. So there again the fire will continue to burn. So this is the additional threat. So yeah, grease fire in the ventilation system is the correct answer. Question number 52. As an extinguishing agent, foam dash. Answer is conducts electricity. So whatever the foam, either it is a high expansion foam or low expansion foam, this foam is a mixture of air, foam concentrate and water. So when the water is present in the foam, then definitely the water is a good conductor of electricity. So the answer is it conducts electricity. Question number 53. A foam type portable fire extinguisher is most useful in fighting a fire in dash oil drums. So oil drums is the right answer because the foam type extinguishers are used to fight the fire involving flammable liquids. Question number 54. A fire hose has a dash. Answer is a male coupling at the nozzle end and a female coupling at the hydrant end. So that is how the fire hose is designed. So the hydrant, which is a male coupling, so you need to have a hose with a female coupling to connect to the hydrant end, and similarly a male coupling at the nozzle end is required to connect the female part of the nozzle. Question number 55. An advantage of an ABC dry chemical over a carbon dioxide extinguisher is dash. The answer is multi-purpose extinguishing ability. ABC dry chemical powder extinguisher means we can use this extinguisher to fight the fire involving A class, B class and C class fire. So this is basically a monoammonium phosphate, so which can be used in any type of fires A, B or C. Question number 56. A fire has broken out on the stern of your vessel. You should maneuver your vessel so that the wind dash. The answer is comes over the bow. So that means when the fire is happening at the aft part of the ship, right? So you have to get out of the fire reaching your forward of the ship. So you have to maneuver in such a way the wind is blowing towards your forward part of the ship. That is called bow. So that the fire happening in the stern, that is aft side of the ship, will go towards the water side. So it will not spread the fire on the midship or forward part of your ship. Question number 57. A fire is discovered in the forepeak of your vessel at sea. The wind is from ahead at 35 knots. You should dash. The answer is change the course and put the stern to the wind. So in this case, the fire is happening at the forward part of your ship, that is in the forepeak. So if you are not altering the vessel, because of the wind, the fire may spread to the stern part of your ship also. So in that case, what we have to do is you have to maneuver in such a way so that the wind is blowing on the stern of the ship, so that the forward part of the fire will go towards the water side. Question number 58. And aluminium powder fire is classified as class dash. The answer is D. So all the fire involving the flammable metals, okay, it is classified as class D fire. Question number 59. A fire starts in a switchboard due to a short circuit. This is which class of fire? The answer is C. So class C fire means the fire involving electrical faults. Okay. So definitely a switchboard fire is an electrical fire. So this will belong to class C. Question number 60. A portable dry chemical fire extinguisher discharged by dash. Answer is pressure from a small CO2 cartridge on the extinguisher. In DCP extinguishers, the powder will be stored inside the container. And when you operate these fire extinguishers, this powder comes out of the nozzle with a pressure. So for that, some sort of device should be there to pressurize the powder inside that extinguisher. So in the portable DCP type, there will be a CO2 cartridge. So when you puncture the CO2 cartridge, the pressure of the released CO2 will push out or drive the dry chemical extinguishers present inside the bottle. So the answer is a pressure from a small CO2 cartridge on the extinguisher.